Hey everyone, this is Jyotika and welcome to your 21st and the last HTML5 tutorial. Today, let's talk about some of the things we have learned so far, and I'm going to do that by giving you 15 tips for creating a good HTML code. While doing that, I'm also going to touch upon a few things like HTML entities and HTML comments that we have missed in our previous tutorials. And in the end, I'm also going to talk about what you can do next after learning HTML. In an ideal world, you will rarely code alone. Instead, you will always be working and collaborating with other developers, which is why it is very important to write a consistent, clean, and tidy HTML code that is easy for others to read and understand. So let's look at the 15 tips for creating a good HTML code. Number 1. Always declare the document type as the first line in your document. It helps browsers to display the web pages correctly. Number 2. Never skip the title element. The title element is the most important element and is required in any HTML document. It defines that little title in the browser toolbar. Moreover, if you want search engines like Google to list your web page higher in the search results, then you should make the title as accurate and meaningful as possible. Number 3. Add the lang and charset attributes. To ensure proper interpretation and correct search engine indexing, both the language and the character encoding should be defined as early as possible in an HTML document. The lang attribute is written inside the HTML tag to declare the language of the web page. And the charset attribute goes inside the meta tag. It helps the browser understand which characters and symbols to use in the web page. Number 4. Always set the viewport by including this meta element in the head element of all your web pages. It gives the browser instructions on how to control the page's dimensions and scaling. Here's an example of a web page without the viewport meta tag and the same web page with the viewport meta tag as seen on a cell phone. And you can see the example on the right, which has the viewport set, looks much better than the one on the left without a viewport meta tag. Number 5. Use lowercase element and attribute names. HTML allows mixing uppercase and lowercase letters in element and attribute names. However, I would recommend you all to use lowercase names because, first of all, lowercase is easier to write. It looks cleaner and most developers normally use lowercase letters, so it will make everyone's life easier. Number 6. Close all elements. In HTML, you do not have to close all elements. For example, the P element here. The browser will understand what you meant and will usually correct it for you, but not necessarily always. If you don't close some other elements, your page might not look like what you expected it to be. Number 7. Use semantic elements. HTML is meant to provide semantic or meaningful structure to documents in the form of headers, footers, lists, articles, and other elements. It is not meant to be used for visual presentation. That is what CSS is for. This means that you should try to limit your HTML to the minimum and the most meaningful elements necessary to define the structure of your document. Don't just fill your document with a lot of nested div tags to achieve a particular layout on your page. Number 8. Always specify alt, width, and height for images. The alt attribute is very important as it will be shown to the users if the image for some reason cannot be displayed. Screen readers will also read the alt text allowed to people using them. Width and height reduce flickering of the page because the browser uses this size provided by us to reserve space for the image before loading. Number 9. Avoid long code lines. When using an editor, sometimes it becomes quite annoying and inconvenient to scroll right and left to read the code. So always try to avoid too long code lines by breaking your code into different lines by pressing the Enter or Return key. It will not affect the functionality of your code as more than one blank space is disregarded by the browser. And that brings us to our next tip. Number 10. Avoid unnecessary blank lines, spaces and indentation. Do not add blank lines, spaces or indentations without a reason. For readability, add blank lines to separate large or logical code blocks. And always add at least two spaces of indentation when nesting the elements. Number 11. Use consistent naming style for your files. Some web servers are case sensitive about file names. SanFrancisco.jpg cannot be accessed as SanFrancisco.jpg. If you use a mix of uppercase and lowercase, you have to be aware of this. And if you move from a case insensitive to a case sensitive server, even small errors will break your web. To avoid these problems, always stick to a consistent style of file names, be it lowercase, camel case, or dashes and hyphens. Number 12. Use comments to describe your code. HTML comments are not displayed by the browser, but they can help document your HTML source code. So someone else or even you reading your own code later will be able to understand what a particular part of code does. You can add them to your HTML document by using the following syntax: opening angle bracket, exclamation point, two dashes, then whatever you want to write, and then two dashes, and a closing angle bracket. You can also use a shortcut. In Sublime, just press Command and forward slash and then write the content inside. So do check out the shortcuts for your editor. And you can see the parts of text inside our special brackets have turned gray. And if you look in the browser, they are not shown anywhere on our page. You can also comment out entire sections of code by selecting and pressing Command plus slash. If you are testing something and don't want that part to display in the browser. So comments are also great for debugging HTML because you can comment out lines of code one at a time to search for errors. Number 13. Use entities. Let's say you wanted to add a copyright symbol on your webpage. How would you do it? Most keyboards don't have a copyright key. So you could just copy it from somewhere on the web and paste it in your HTML document. And great, you will get the copyright symbol on your page. But the problem is immediately seen on another browser. In Safari, you can see some weird characters along with the symbols. So not all browsers will show the copied symbols correctly. So how do we solve this problem? That's where HTML entities come into play. An HTML entity is a piece of text that begins with an ampersand and ends with a semicolon. They are especially helpful to use in place of characters that are difficult to type with a standard keyboard, like the copyright symbol or many currency symbols. So let's type the entity for copyright symbol, which is ampersand copy semicolon. And you can see the symbol is correctly displayed in Safari as well. Entities are also frequently used to display reserved characters, which would otherwise be interpreted as HTML code, and also invisible characters like non-breaking spaces. For example, if you use the less than sign, the browser interprets any text that follows as a tag. But if you wanted to display this as just a less than sign, then you can use this HTML entity. Similarly, you can add extra spaces in your code by using this entity. There are many such entities for various symbols and characters, and I am going to put a link to a reference chart in the description below. Number 14. Always validate your code. Sometimes, or should I say most of the times, your code may not work correctly the first time. So make sure you run your code through a validator after every few lines of code. And that will help you find places where you haven't closed tags or written a wrong spelling or any other incorrect syntax. This is especially important if you nest tags. Trust me, it will save you a lot of your precious time. A good tool for validating your code is this W3C Markup Validation Service at validator.w3.org. Number 15. Check your code on multiple browsers. Even if your page looks great when you are running it in, say, Chrome, make sure you check it out on Firefox. If it looks great on Safari, make sure you check it on Chrome. It's really important that you make sure that your pages can be reachable to the greatest number of people possible. And really, the only way you can do this is by keeping your code simple and succinct. It's very easy to get carried away and try to use every possible tag you can to show how much you know about HTML. But you should remember that not all browsers support all the HTML tags. So always use the most specific tag possible and test your code on as many browsers as you can. So yeah, these were some of the best practices and coding conventions for creating a good HTML code. So what should you do next? If you have found HTML interesting, what you really want to do is practice, practice, practice. Keep writing code, keep using tags, make simple web pages. If you have been using Notepad, try Sublime. If you have been using Sublime, try Visual Studio Code. Keep working with different editors. If you ever run into a problem when you're coding, you should stop after say 20 minutes max and go take a break. Think about something else, go get help from someone. And you really need to learn to look things up on your own. Because there's so much more to know about HTML, especially as the language slowly continues to evolve. And there are many great resources out there for finding out more about HTML. MDN WebDocs is a fantastic place to find reference documentation. W3 Schools is another great resource for learning HTML. If you want to read the official documentation of the HTML specifications, then visit this site. I've put the link in description. The HTML specification was most recently numbered version 5. Which is what I name these tutorials, since the term HTML5 is widely used as a buzzword to refer to modern web technologies. But since HTML is slowly and continuously changing, the representatives making these specifications decided to call the most current version as the HTML Living Standard. And we have learned things from both HTML5 and the Living Standard. And whatever is written in the documents on this website is a source of truth about HTML. In fact, there is a special copy of it that's been simplified and formatted especially for designers and developers to read. And finally, the most important thing you probably want to do next is learn about cascading style sheets or CSS. CSS is a method you are going to use to take your plain HTML file and make it look awesome. Knowing both HTML and CSS makes for a powerful combination. And the good news is, I will be starting a CSS tutorial series next, and I really hope you all will join me for that. So do stay tuned by subscribing and pressing that bell icon. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.